nhất sang một ngày mà sẽ yêu đàn tiên là một nhìn thì tôi sợ hàn đá vào biên tài I said to him, I have also my appointment today in Ma'a Church for the communion service. But he said to me, the divine worship in upper room is 8:30. So that is why I cannot disagree with him, because after this divine worship, I will be going out for my another appointment. So it is by God's grace that we are still alive today. Amen. Hindi pa ito na isoon na din sa itong iglesia sa Apelong. Every time I come here, there is always an improvement. So pag anin ako sa una, hindi pa nito na ninyo. Pero karoon, yung condition na kita na. So, praise the Lord for this beautiful house of worship and we will worship our God in spirit and in truth. This morning, our topic this morning for our study is entitled The Dream Team. When Jesus came to this earth, it is his dream to be with the Jews, to become his teammate, to evangelize the world. But sad to say that the Jews did not receive him. Wala din sa ginawa ng Panginoon sa mga Hudiyo, that is why until now, the Jews still waiting for the coming of the Messiah. I was privileged to be in Israel last year, 2015, and I took picture of these Jews who are always at the wall of the wall of Jericho, at the waiting wall, praying for the coming of the Messiah every day. They will come to this waiting wall in order for them to pray to God. Daghan kayo mga tao, matingala ka na magkabaga ang tao. Magsigiog ganto sa waiting wall. Magsigiog pray for the coming of the Messiah. But sad to say that their faith, nila mapatuo mga isuon sa pagkulat at magkaroon mula rin nila maapdian. Wala pa yun maabot ang inang ipaabot. So, our text for this morning, the key text of our study is found in John 12, chapter 12, verse 32. In King James Version, it says, if I am lifted up from the earth, will draw all men to myself. And in verse 46, he says, I have come as a light into the world, that whoever believes in me should not abide in darkness. Our objective of our study today, brothers and sisters, it's all about what Paul says in 1 John 9, 55 and 56, that we should run with a purpose to obtain that incorruptible prize. We should run for a purpose. And this is what I mean, so we're going to have a sigil at ang kagandagan, sigil at ang kalagan, ito ang kitay, tumob ito sa mga pangalagan. So we should run for a purpose. The purpose is to win the prize. When you attend a marathon, you have a purpose in life, just to finish or to win the prize. But God placed in front of us the prices that He will give if we will become successful or we will be overcomers of all the obstacles in this world. These are the prices that God placed in front of us. The incorruptible price. Remember that these are the incorruptible price. It says in Revelation 2:7, to him who overcomes, I will give to eat from the tree of life. This is one of the prizes that God laid in front of us if we will be one of those who overcome. Number two, Revelation 2:11. He who overcomes shall not be hurt by the second death. Iyon na may soon. Dili basta-basta ni nga mga prizes na iandam sa Ginoo alang nato. He prepares incorruptible prizes. Revelation 2 verse 17. To him who overcomes, I will give some of the hidden manna to eat, that I will give him a white stone and on the stone a new name written which no one knows except him who receives it. Number 4. Revelation 2:26. He who overcomes and keeps my works until the end, to him I will give power over all, over the nations. Number 5. He who overcomes shall be clothed in the white garments and will not blot out his name from the book of life. Number 6. He who overcomes, will I make him a pillar in the temple of my God, and he shall go out no more, and I will write upon him a new name. And number 7. Revelation 3:21. To him who overcomes, I will grant to sit with me on my throne. And number 8, the last one. He who overcomes shall inherit all things, and I will be his God, and he shall be my son. These are the incorruptible prizes that God prepares for those who will overcome. Our study this morning portrays three groups of people that illustrates the importance of preparation. The importance of preparation. Number 1, from the secular world, and number 2, from the Old Testament, and number 3, from the New Testament. These are the three groups of people. Number 1, from the secular world. In 1992, Barcelona Olympic, USC, they have that what they call USA Dream Team. So kayo ang NBA karon kay championship ng world sa mga kining NBA Cleveland o Golden State Warrior. But in 1992, these players selected from the NBA, they called it the Dream Team. And one of the players in the Dream Team 1992, Barcelona Olympic, is Michael Jordan. You know him. One of the interviews that Michael Jordan had, gipangutan na siya sa usa ka newscaster. What qualified them to be part of that dream team? According to Michael Jordan, he practiced harder than anyone. He became famous in basketball in his time because according to him, he practiced harder than anyone. And the second one, he determines to do what other man want. He practiced harder than anyone. Kung nag-practice ang mga uban na players, na practice sila dito sa basketball court, pre-practice basketball in the swimming pool. Una na dito siya magdadagdagan sa swimming pool. Pagdawas niya sa swimming pool, pwede na niya kusugan ko dati. Because he practiced harder than anyone. In our rest of our Christian life, brothers and sisters, if we would like to become a good Christian closer to Jesus Christ, we have to practice Christianity more than anyone else. He made his best superior than anyone else. This was recorded, I saw in the Weekly Standard magazine. The second one, the Old Testament. There is also a team, the Gideon's Dream Team. This is recorded in the book of Judges 6:11-7:22. When the Lord said to Gideon, tingnan siya sa Ginoo, Gideon, you will become the commander of the soldiers of the Israelites to fight against the Midianites. Nakita nila ang Midianites, pagkalakad kayo mura grasshopper dito sa valley. And Gideon made an announcement to the people of Israel to enlist all young people, men, to become soldiers to fight against the Midianites. There are more than 30,000 responded. 30,000 of them responded. But the Lord said to Gideon, 30,000 is too much. You have to say to them that whoever faithful and afraid, let him go. Ignan siya sa Ginoo. Kinsa itong lahat ito, ignan siya. If they are afraid, they will have to go. And 22,000 went home that very moment. Only 10,000 remained. And the Lord said to Gideon, 10,000 is too much. Gideon is quite worried because he could see the Midianites at the valley. It's like a grasshopper. Pagkalakad kayo sa mga tao. Kung yan, 10,000, even 30,000 is not enough. But the Lord said, that's too much. Bring them to the river. And I will be the one to choose who is the right one to be at your team. And at that moment, they go, you know, everyone who spoke up water in their hands to drink. Those are the people. May Muhammad, Pagabilibor, and 300, only 300 remains out of 10,000 people. And the 300 men of Gideon, iingat ko si Gideon sa Ginoo. Ingon ang ino si Gideon, tingali, masitagaan mo si Ginoo o kini. Nindot kayo ng armas kay 300 at ang iyong soldiers. But the Lord gave them no armor in battle. The Lord gave them a torch, a pitcher, and a trumpet. Iyon si Gideon, so may mahi mong katuan na solo, pitcher, naway solo. Kunya, trumpet, kanakabing trumpet, roto, maura na iyakas sa Ginoo.
But a great victory was won that night by the act of God and the courage of Gideon and the faith and valor of his noble soldiers. This now, look, Gideon's dream team. God's dream team in this Old Testament, the 10 virgins. Ang 10 virgins mga Exodus represents the Seventh-day Adventist Church today. This is a present dream team of Jesus. We know the history of the 10 virgins that is recorded in Matthew 25. Verse 1, it says, "Then shall the kingdom of heaven be likened unto 10 virgins, which took their lamps and went forth to meet the bridegroom." And in verse 3, "They that were foolish took their lamps and took no oil with them." In verse 4, "But the wise took oil in their vessels with their lamps. When the bridegroom tarried, they are slumbered and slept. And at midnight there was a cry made, Behold, the bridegroom coming. Go ye out to meet him. Then all those virgins arose and trimmed their lamps. And the foolish said unto the wise, Give us oil, for our lamps are gone out." In verse 9, "But the wise answered, saying, No, not so, lest there be not enough for us and you. But go ye rather to them that said, and buy for yourself. And while they went to buy, the bridegroom came. And they that were ready went in with him to be married, to the marriage. And the door was shut." In verse 11, "Afterward came also the other virgins, Lord, Lord, open to us. But in verse 12 he says, But he answered and said, Verily I say unto you, I know you not." I highlighted the word "I know you not." I know you not. Because for us Christians who always come to worship at Sabbath, we have our family worship at home. But at the end, the Lord will say to us, "I know you not." This is the saddest thing that a Seventh-day Adventist member could hear during the coming of our Lord Jesus. This is the focus of our study. Those who were not able to enter were those who don't have the extra oil, the ones the Lord knew not. Kato walang kasunod sa mga marriage ceremony. Katong mga tao na wala extra oil according to the parable, and those people the Lord knew na. I know you na. The word "know" in the original language, which is in Greek, it is called kenosko, meaning began to know, progress in knowledge. There is also another meaning, which is called oida, the fullness of knowledge, know him perfectly. You stand in no relation to me, meaning you have no knowledge of me, you don't know me perfectly or deeply. How are we going to have that extra oil? Number one, by diligent study of the scriptures. Ellen White says, "The Bible was not written for scholars alone. It was designed for common people. The great cross necessary for salvation is as clear as noonday." Steps of Christ, page 61. By diligent study of the scriptures. This is the way that we may be able to have that extra oil. The extra oil is the knowledge, our knowledge about God. That is our extra oil. If we want to have a good relationship with our Lord Jesus Christ, we have to study our Bibles diligently. Ang problema na ito karoon. Because we have all the access to the Bible, but Satan is always blocking us to study our Bibles. Sige, nagbasa sa ito ang mga text messages na wala yung texto. Dinasa ito ang mga symbols. Wala na yung chapter na ang mga text messages. Poros na yun na siya versikulo. Ako pa muli yung nahinunan. It would not strengthen our faith. According to Mrs. White, Satan is not interested for those people who are already peace. Ito mga tao kaya na din ang ito siya mo tagadato. But according to the Great Controversy, chapter 34, in one occasion when Satan and when the Lord called his angels for a meeting, Satan is also coming with him. And one of his best agenda, ingon siya nga, hindi na po mangilabot na ako ba ng mga tao. Panhaan po ninyo during your worship time. And according to Mrs. White, Satan is in attendance when we have our worship. Today, he is inside our church. Although we do not see him, but he has angels inside the church. Moving on that, during divine worship, pagkalamig yun kayo itatulog. Because Satan is present with us. He is talking all the time that we could not hear the message coming from God. He is blocking our minds to wonder things outside our worship. Hindi siya gusto na manurture ka sa itong spiritual life because that is the only one, that is the only thing, that is the only way that we will strengthen our faith. We will have that extra oil when the day will come. Next all, Satan has many agents according to Mrs. White. He has all the avenues to tempt us. Magsimba man ito, magdala ka sa itong cellphone, magkalit lang siya yung text. Ay magkalit yung text, ay magkalit yung panawa. That will distract our minds to focus on the Word of God. Ellen White says, we should study the Scriptures diligently in order for us to have that strength. The second one, we should not take the testimony of any man as to what the Scripture teaches, but should study the words of God for ourselves. You have noticed that those foolish virgins ask oil from the five who are wise. Nanayot sila. But the wise virgins told them that this is enough for us. Our oil is enough for us. That is why Sister White says, you should study the words of God for ourselves. Because if the time will come, connecting one relationship to our God is our personal relationship. We will not pass it to other people. That is personal. The extra oil is personal. So we should have to study our Bible personally so that we will be able to have a personal connection with our God and a personal knowledge about Him. We should study. Di man tayo maminaw lang sa upad ng morning, muna giingon sa Bible. That is why Sister White says we should not take the testimony of any man as to what the scriptures teach, but should study the words of God for ourselves. Second one, by neglecting fellowship with one another. By not neglecting. The first, in order for us to have that extra oil, is to have to be diligent in our study of our Bibles. Number two, by not neglecting fellowship with one another. There are some brethren na may consider na hindi na lang kumusimba, eh, pwede lang ako mag-study because may balay. Pwede lang ako magtanaw o video ni this city. Ako lang isa na simpa-simpa sa balay. Kung sa inyo ni Mrs. White, those who are really seeking for communion with God will be seen in the prayer meeting, faithful to do their duty and earnest and anxious to reap all the benefits they can give. Namin tayo sa kaigulang na bumol. Ginan siya sa mga anak na nai. May pati na lang ang mga ato simbahan kay bumol mo ka. Di maghihapon ka makatulong sa misahe. Dali na lang ka sa palay. Pero yung mga tigulang, bisan pag hindi ko kadulong, musim pagod ko. Kaya naka-hinomdog daw siya. Nga doon na tayo usap ka, tao, nga nagtimpa o tubig, ang igamit basket. Some other people look at him as foolish man. Yabang ni Tawana, nagtimpa o tubig sa atabay, basket ang igamit. Kung sumay, masulog na ng basket na inikuha sa tubig pagkas ng dalag. But the other person noticed that many times that did what they call foolish person dip the basket inside the well. Sa sige niya, tusuntoslo dito na hinlo man ang basket. Hinlo ang basket. Munang ingon sa tigula, musimpa lang yun ko. Kaya bisabi niyo ka dulo, basta makasimpa ko, mahinlo ko. Mga isuon, lipay na nita kay din siguro sa inyo ang mga ibumol. Katumo pinatanan. We should have a communion with God sa ato mga prayer meeting. Kumusta ato ang mga Wednesday prayer meeting? Inunani mo kung katatanan. You know, Sister White says, that Wednesdays, Friday meetings is one of the barometers of our faith. Muna'y usa sa mga sultanan, may suwag sa kapag-uho, pinatali, simbang mentoris, sabado lang itong siguro ko. Muna'y sabado ko, tanga ko. Kapalo mo mga isuho ko sa meeting sa STA. Ang STA mo na itong program kada sabado, Sabbath School Divine AY. Una yung STA. If we neglect Sabbath School, Divine Worship pa tayo, nagkukumar ko, muli na mo, di rin mo may so, di. Kung yan, di mo simba ko sa Sabbath School, ang simba mo sa Sabbath School lang, kung Divine, istira mo mo. Di mo mabalik mo niya sa AY, istira mo may so. Kulang ang atong pagka-STA. If you are a true STA, you should be here from Sabbath School Divine to AY. Because that is part of our worship. Faithful to do your duty, earnest and anxious. We should sustain a loss when we neglect the privilege of associating together to strengthen and encourage one another in the service of God. The truth of His Word lost their vividness and importance in our minds. Our hearts cease to be enlightened and aroused by their sanctifying influence, and we decline in His spirituality.
Kamu may suod na nakasuway o kanandinit na bitaw mo simpa kayo.
We can observe by ourselves.
Ngamura din naman kaganahan mo simpa. Di na po kaganahan mo hampo.
We will decline in our spirituality if we neglect fellowship with one another.
Number three, my soul, the last one,
establish a prayer for life.
We will establish a prayer for life.
We should pray in the family circle,
family worship,
and above all, we must not neglect sacred prayer, for this is the life of the soul.
It is impossible for the soul to flourish while prayer is neglected.
Family worship, my soul. How is our family worship?
Sa akin, hindi mo tumatas ang buwang worship. Mabitawin, my soul, na
the peril of technology.
Because kanihan to po ng panahon na wala pa'y mga kuryente.
Muna yun, maayo pa ito sa una ng primitive Christianity.
Primitive Christianity, my soul, because dito sa mga sa bukit sa una,
bisag wala, bisuga,
magpapakas kami sa painom sa simbahan, kayo kayo.
Ang among sulog, mga isuod, na aman is pastor, bayan,
ay malumin din sa dito sa among bukit sa una, kaya aman ang disiplina sa una.
Magkukod miglang kayo, kay manimba mi, kaya na kami sulog, painom dito sa simbahan.
Puno ang simbahan.
But now, pagkahayag sa iyong nagianan, magsuod,
but we have no time to go to church.
We have all the vehicle to carry us to church.
Ating mga service sa unang magpaktas lang pero makanto, pero karoon na natin service, hindi na kita makanto.
Accessible sa tanan ng mga sakinan ng Panginoon sa simbahan, but we do not afford to do the church.
Family worship, my soul, sa akin, ito na lang dali-dali.
For those na nagulat sa mga teleserye ng mga gigwanan, nga gisurvive ba yan, may mga sila na dali ko na ito ng worship kayo. Sa lila na karoon, pag-advertisement, ato na yung daliro, atong kanta, first lang sa lang kong puros.
Ayun, ampo, ayaw patas na o ampo, dali lang.
Our prayer worship, family worship, mga isoon.
Kuwan na lang, mura na lang o ceremonial. Wala ka kaayoy,
bene.
Ang leksyon may punta na. Ang kanang leksyon, hindi lang kayo natunan.
Ay lang, basahan lang matisto sa leksyon.
Basahan lang ang yatanan. Tutal na naman natin ay comments.
Mga iso, this is reality in our time.
How are we going to have that extra hour? Establish a prayer for life.
In closing, mga iso,
preparation is not an option, but it is a must.
This is the only time we could prepare ourselves for the coming of Jesus Christ.
We are busy in our temporal, on all our temporary assignments in this world, but we neglect to prepare for the very important part of our lives, which is to prepare ourselves for the coming of Jesus.
Ellen White says, those who do not know appreciate, study, and dearly prize the word of God spoken by His servants will have cause to mourn bitterly hereafter.
Magmahal kita mo na Isor.
Muna, namin ka sa tanto, nanaapay panahon na magtuon ka sa Biblia, magtuon ka sa ato ang sa pulong sa Ginoo earnestly.
Because this is the only time we could
have that relationship with our God. I saw the Lord in judgment will at the close of time walk through the earth. The fearful plagues will begin to fall. Then, those who have despised God's word, those who have lightly esteemed it shall wander from sea to sea. They shall run to and fro to seek the word of the Lord and shall not find it. Time will come, may soon, may muntang asa na matungkulo sa Ginoo. Gusto ko mabasa, gusto ko maminaw, wali, gusto ko maging fellowship sa retreat. I want to pray to God, but it's too late. While we still have time, we must diligently study our Bibles. We should not neglect fellowship with one another. Establish a prayerful life, and by doing it, we will be able to know Jesus perfectly and be able to have our extra strength when the time of crisis will come. We will be one of those who will overcome. Run with a purpose and determined to win the incorruptible prize. Like the man of valor, Gideon and his 300, who did not trust in sex, but trust in God with all their hearts, have become victorious. Jesus dreamed that if he will be lifted up from earth, will draw all men to himself. Mugi na ang ihatlong sa Ginoo ng Isoon, no? Nakita. Makikuban na lang ito kaniya. Because he died for us. That is how important we are in the sight of Jesus Christ. He died for us. He dreamed to be with us. We are to make the best of our present opportunities. There will be no other provision given to us in which to prepare for heaven. This is our only and last opportunity to form characters that will fit us for the future home which the Lord has prepared for all who are obedient to His commandments. Brothers and sisters, this morning, Jesus Christ is waiting for us. This is the only time that we could have the closer walk with Him. This is the only time na magpundo tayo ng strength when the time will come na malisol kung may soul makabarong maghati tayo. Can we stand in the terrible time of trouble when we neglect the study of the scriptures, when we neglect fellowship with each other, when we neglect a prayer for life? So my brothers and sisters, this is my earnest prayer and desire that this message of ours today will find place in our hearts, that when Jesus will come, no one of us will be lost, but we will be home together in that beautiful kingdom that God has prepared for all of us. May the Lord bless us this morning. This is my prayer.